You are listening to Making Sense with Alison Blackler. Welcome to Making Sense, our second episode. My name is Alison. Thank you for all of your messages of support after our first episode 2 weeks ago. Thank you for listening in and helping us make this show a success. Today in the studio, I am accompanied by George, who is most definitely my wingman. George is the much needed technical and production side of the show. He's a musician in his own right and passionate about music. He says he isn't keen to be on the microphone at this stage, but maybe one day we'll watch this space. So in the last show, we chatted about New Year's resolutions and goals and how often we often give up on some of our ideas about this point in January. I proposed the idea of the main focus being for us to be happy. How have you got on? I'm really interested and would love to hear from you. Did you manage to set yourself one small thing that you were going to do to help you feel happier? Not trying to do too much at once, otherwise we get completely overwhelmed, and this is often at the heart of us quitting. Doing something that's one small thing, it takes the pressure away from not acknowledging these big goals that we set ourselves often at this time of the year. This works as well because we can achieve a small goal, and that is what makes us feel happier and more fulfilled. This approach helps us to be much more in the moment, and being in the moment is certainly something to work towards. As humans, we spend a lot of our time worrying about the future or dwelling too much on the past. I have a little metaphor that I often use, and I'll just quickly describe it for you now. So imagine you're driving along in a car and you've got your hands on the steering wheel. Your hands on the steering wheel is the now. It's the present. You can drive wherever you want. The past is represented by a rearview mirror, which is small and dark, although it has a purpose. The rearview mirror keeps us safe, but from only one perspective. Imagine you drove your car next time, focusing too much on the past. What would happen? Yes, you would crash, I hear you say. So being in the present is being in the now, and now is where you find happiness and contentment. So you will find it easier to be in the moment and be happier. Okay, so for this show, let's have a think about what we're doing today. In this show, the main theme we have chosen is resilience. We will be looking at what it is, why it is important, and what you can do to build more. So now more than ever, we are all having to dig deep, manage our emotions, keep motivated, and rely on our resilience. Later in the show, we will also be focusing on what is success, and our quote of the show is from Mr. Mandela himself. We will have some music from Gloria Gaynor, Bon Jovi, Wilson Phillips, Billy Joel, and many more, so do stay tuned. But we've chosen music with a powerful message to start us off, and we have chosen Kelly Clarkson, Stronger. So just enjoy as we have a little start off today.
Feels warmer sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. Baby, you don't know me, 'cause you're dead. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. What's that fever lighter? Doesn't mean I'm over, 'cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stronger. Just me. kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stronger. Just me, myself and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Welcome back. Lyrics of songs are so powerful, aren't they? I particularly like the line in that song, doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. And I think thinking about that, being okay in your own company is something that is so important and something that quite a lot of people need to work on. So something we can come back to at a later date. Okay, so for now, I just want to talk to you about success. Thinking about last episode, and we were talking about New Year's resolutions and how we can set them and how we can often fail. So what success is to one person can be regarded as almost as a shortcoming or even a failure to someone else. Most people agree that success means achieving or accomplishing or reaching something that makes them feel content and fulfilled. For some people, measuring success is done by money. Although money doesn't automatically equal life success or indeed happiness. I think the most important thing for us to keep an eye on is the pace at which we achieve our success. And this is very personal. A starting point is not the same for us all, and the journey we take to reach our goals can vary, with many avenues and speed bumps along the way. This makes measuring success and therefore comparing it impossible. We are all different, and so there can be a lot of pressure on what we perceive as being successful. So let's look at the flip side of that now and look at what about failure. So for me, rather than seeing anything as a failure and seeing that as a problem, we can talk about it differently. Success can be achieved by learning from our mistakes. We have all had challenges that shape our lives, and through those challenges, we'll grow. Just because we don't always achieve what we have set out to do doesn't mean that we have failed. There will always be a learning. We can all have the determination and motivation to move us forward, although for one reason we quit, and because it's not always clear in what it is that we want. To recognise whether we have our internal sat-nav is taking you in the right direction, you may have a good idea of where you want to be heading and what you want to aim for. It is common to feel unsettled in life and have no idea what you really want. The mind doesn't like it when it doesn't know, and it certainly needs certainty. We need to be clear on what it is that we want and what it will be like when we've got it. So, making sure that we have small goals and little stepping stones is the way to great achievement. But we must remember to keep focused on what it is that we're focusing on and what we want as well. Keep chunking down your goals and ideas of what it is that you want. It is also vital from the mind's perspective to celebrate all our wins, big or small. Our minds need this. And as adults particularly, we are not great at stopping to acknowledge our achievements. If you think about children, they are rewarded and given positive praise all day long. Even when they haven't managed to get something right, we still encourage them to keep trying. We seem to stop doing this as adults. And yet it is vital for our self-worth, self-belief, confidence and resilience. Okay, so we're going to look at resilience a little bit later, but firstly, let's have another tune while we digest what we've just been talking about. So I think, George, we've now got lined up Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi. So enjoy.
Listen to Wirral Wave. They can't touch you for it. Wirral Wave, Wave,
Wave, Wave. Welcome back. You're listening to Making Sense on Wirral Wave Radio. Just remember, we would love to hear from you. Please, please message the show. Tell us what you think. and send us any requests for your favourite tune and we will put it on to the next show. You can contact the show, makingsense@wirralwave.co.uk. You can also follow us on our socials. So Facebook is Two Minds UK. Instagram is Alison Two Minds. Or you can come on Facebook for the radio show, which is Wirral Wave. And also the Instagram is Wirral Wave. So we'd love you to follow us and give us some feedback. Okay, so we've said the main theme for this show is resilience. So firstly, let's think about what it is. It is certainly one term that is spoken about a lot, particularly in business these days, and probably because of the current situation we've all been in. I've certainly been running a lot of leadership and team workshops over the Zoom, over lockdown, and resilience has been a topic that I've covered a lot of. Resilience refers to our ability to be able to adapt to success, stressful even, situations or crises. The more resilient people are, they're able to roll with the punches and adapt to adversity without lasting difficulties. Less resilient people have a harder time with stress and life changes, both major and minor. So research shows that learning, adopting simple habits that are proven to improve resilience has a huge payoff. Being more resilient means you're able to navigate life's challenges from a place of strength and conviction. And this skill has perhaps been more important than ever because of the situation we've been in. The emotional load that the pandemic has given us all really means that resilience needs to be, we need to be stronger and have a higher place in our thoughts. Resilience is important for several reasons. It enables us to develop mechanisms for protection against experiences which could be overwhelming. It also helps us to maintain balance in our lives during difficult or stressful times. And it can also protect us from the development of some mental health difficulties and issues. So really have a little start to think now, what does resilience actually mean to you? Because it can mean different things slightly to each of us. It's good to stop and think about what it is that it means to you, because we are all different. Resilience is achieved through consistent progress that we make towards each day and towards each goal. Each of these goals needs to have some sort of a benchmark, which we've already talked about. One small thing, remember, is my way of talking about that. To live as humans, life is quite risky, I suppose. We have to be willing to take the risk because there is a lot of uncertainty out there. And to know when to rest and also to be unafraid to be different from everyone else, I think is another really strong point that we need to think about. So to be resilient, we also must view challenges as a catalyst that inspires us to develop ourselves. Life's challenges will absolutely test us to the core. It can be scary. Yet it is exactly when a challenge brings us to our knees that we make inner wisdom, inner integrity, and often learn the most important gems about ourselves. Resilience is our ability to survive and flourish through our traumas, our stresses, responsibilities, and challenges offered by life. Let's think about some of the signs of being resilient. Having a good support network. Knowing when to shout up and tap into that support network is critical. Often we think that by speaking up, we feel weak, and actually it's the opposite. Maintaining those positive relationships, thinking about who you mix with and ensuring that they have a positive influence on your life is also important. Having a good self-image, not being too critical of ourselves. As humans, we are super critical of ourselves, and actually trying to think of techniques and ways of minimising that is important. And having a positive attitude. This can feel difficult at times, although pushing yourself to see something positive in your day is critical and does help build resilience. Having the capacity to make realistic plans. And the realistic plan is the most important part here. Being able to keep something that is that one small thing, I keep saying it, but it's so important, that one small thing that we can then carry over and make that plan, make that bigger goal happen. being able to acknowledge that step, that little part of the progress, is also really important. Okay, so let's have a little tune again, George. I think we're ready to play Wilson Phillips' Hold On.
Why do you lock yourself up in these chains? No one can change your life except for you. Don't ever let anyone step all over you. Just open your heart and your mind. Is it really fair to feel this way inside? Turn around and say goodbye. Until then, baby, are you gonna let him hold you down and make you cry? Don't you know, things will change, things will go your way. If you hold on for one more day, can you hold on for one more day? Things will go your way. Hold on for one more day.
Welcome back. Just in case you've just tuned in, we are talking about resilience. That's the theme of our show. And I'm just sharing kind of what resilience is. And we're going to start to explore how we can get more of it in a moment. So let's start to think about how we can get more resilience. Let's face it, in the last few months, if not even more than a few months, we have needed to become more resilient, but also to learn how to manage ourselves. Let's stop now and have a think about this question. How do you collect yourself after a stressful event? What do you do? What do you focus on? You might be already quite a resilient person. I actually believe that we're all super resilient, and often we think we're not. When we look back at some of the things that we've coped with, it just shows us really that we have dug deep and we've found a way. So if you're feeling like you are not a resilient person and you look back at some of the things that you've achieved, just look at the fact that you've actually achieved them and you've actually overcome them. And that tells me that you've got bucket loads of resilience. Okay, so let's have a little think about the forms of resilience and how you can get them. So we've got physical resilience, mental and emotional. So physical resilience, this is your body's ability to adapt to changes, to maintain stamina and strength, and to recover quickly and efficiently. It's a person's ability to function and recover when you're faced with an illness, an accident, or a physical demand. There are so many ways of looking after our physical health. Is there one small thing that you can do to commit to your physical health that you can do differently today or this week? Mental resilience is not just your ability to bounce back, but it's also your capacity to adapt in the face of challenging situations. The key thing there is whilst maintaining some sort of stability. So next, let's look at emotional resilience. And this is not about winning the battle. It is the strength to power through the storm and still keep the sail steady. It means bouncing back from a stressful encounter and not letting it affect our internal motivation. Another way to describe it is when you are able to settle your busy, frantic mind after encountering a negative experience. So often something has happened and we keep it going round and round and round in our heads. It interferes with our motivation, and then our inner thoughts will then tend to go tenfold. And that's something that we really, really can slow down and change. When we are resilient, we are not only adapting ourselves to stress, also disappointment, we also grow and we have insights in how to avoid situations which then can lead us to maybe a different solution or outcome. Let's just have a little light touch on stress management and emotional resilience now. Coping with stress, or better to say, effectively coping with stress, contributes directly towards building resilience. The whole idea of being emotionally resilient revolves around how well you are able to handle stress and get back on track. Getting tied down with a daily stressor of life can be a big reason that we lose our emotional resilience. We become more sensitive, overreactive, and emotionally unbalanced. You might think about that. When you feel emotionally unbalanced, you are likely to be irritable. You are likely to be more snappy. You are that scenario where you catch your something on your clothing and you catch it on a door frame and you nearly pull the door off the wall. That's the kind of thing we're thinking about here. Even a little change of plans can leave us in a state of anxiety and panic. Okay, so I think now it's time for another tune. We're going back to 1975 with Steve Harley and Cockney Rebel, Make Me Smile. Enjoy and give yourself permission to have a little dance round if you fancy.
You've done it all. You've broken every code. And pulled the rebel to the floor. You spoiled the game, no matter what you say. Only metal, what a bore. Blue eyes, blue eyes. How can you tell so many lies? Come up and see me, make me smile. I'll do what you want, running wild. There's nothing left, all gone and run away. Maybe you'll tarry for a while. It's just a test, a game for us to play. Win or lose, it's hard to smile. Resist, resist. From yourself, you have to
Welcome back. So that was a great tune. And I don't know whether any of you remember that tune from the film The Full Monty. But I've got a picture in my mind of the guys up the top of a hill and they are running with their arms out like kids pretending to be little aeroplanes and just the best, just the best. And that is certainly a way of building inner resilience by just being able to have some fun and have a bit of a dance round. So definitely always permission to have a dance when we're listening to tunes here. Okay, so let's keep talking about resilience, which is our topic for today. And let's have a think about how we can build more resilience. So I've got a few kind of tips about what we can do. My first tip is all around self-awareness. Self-awareness is our ability to tune into our own feelings, our internal conflict, and our perception of the world. Through self-awareness, we can gain a deeper understanding of how we feel and how this contributes to our actions. Rather than looking for help outside or blaming the world for our miseries, self-awareness gives us the opportunity to look for answers within. By making us more attuned to our inner world, building self-awareness helps us to become more capable. So the task is to get curious about your behaviours, no judgment, and notice habits that happen when you put yourself into different situations. When you can spot and then admit that you are being held back by something, probably a self-belief or a story from the past, you can make a change. When your relationships are forming a pattern and not working out, you can consider what is buried deep within that needs your attention. Just for clarity, being aware doesn't entail overanalyzing, overthinking, or being paranoid. These behaviors are the ones that you want to move away from. Instead, we want to notice your own reactions to situations and any accompanying thoughts. These interactions can become habitual and become part of us. You are looking out for any negative behaviours, ones like automatic negative thinking, people-pleasing, jumping to conclusions, or adopting the blame position. So, no judgement. We're just noticing. That's our first thing. just noticing what thoughts we've got and what how they make you feel. So, next tip for building more resilience is self-respect. We cannot be self-respecting without counting or depending upon others for our own sense of self-worth. To be resilient, we must develop the ability to self-soothe when things get tough. There are times we must fake it until we make it because we are needing to continue to operate with some sort of sense of composure, regardless of our circumstances. When things are in the way and are particularly stressful, we must tap into our will, to our motivation, to help us to move forward. So, and my next tip for building resilience is persistence. This is our ability to stick with something. This sounds so obvious, although it is vital to have something that we are achieving with or in. If we do not feel that we are committed to something, then our focus drops, our inner motivation is reduced, and we miss an opportunity to build resilience. My next tip for building resilience is focused on others. To be exceptional in life, we must see the good in others. We must notice and value their character or their intelligence or something good about them that brings that into our life. When we are grounded in who we are, we can enjoy celebrating the accomplishments of others as much as we love to see our own success. We are aware that in life there is enough for everyone, and any belief in the opposite of this may block opportunities for us. We deeply believe there is enough love, money, success and passion for everyone. Therefore, we do not need to get or need to be jealous or sabotage the success of others. Okay, my next tip for building resilience is nurturing. It is part of a resilient person's nature to do whatever it takes to get up in the morning to feed and nurture yourself, your children, pets, partner, and anything else in your life. We make sure to exercise, to eat well, and get enough rest. When we are balanced, we are able to create a life experience which feels whole. We avoid working until we drop because we need time to nurture ourselves. No matter the pain in our life, we continue to work hard to support those who depend upon us, whether that's your families, your staff, your friends. This is essential to us because nurturing what and who you are passionate about is a part of who you are at your core. It is this nurturing nature that makes us great friends, great people in life. Nurturing makes us someone others want to have in their lives, and we inspire others to give back to us all that we have to give. I think it's time for a piece of music again, and we have picked My Life by Billy Joel. I hope you enjoy it.
I still belong. Don't get me. Then they'll tell you you can't sleep with somebody else. Ah, but sooner or later you sleep in your own space. Either way, it's okay, you wake up with yourself. I don't need you to worry for me, 'cause I'm alright. I don't want you to tell me it's time to come home. I don't care what you say anymore, this is my life. Go ahead with your own life, leave me alone.
I never said you had to offer me a second chance. I never said I was a victim of circumstance.
I still belong.
Wirral Wave. Listen in.
We're different.
So, let's think about some more tips for building resilience. How are you getting on? Processing what I'm saying, thinking about yourself, making sure that it fits for you. It has to resonate with you. And I'm giving you a lot of tips, but I think then you can pick which one you're going to focus on first. Because remember, my one small thing is the most important thing. It's not about having it all. It's about having something and making a start. So my next tip for building resilience is emotional control. Now, this is our ability to self-control or redirect our feelings. Remember, our emotional brain gets involved 5 times quicker than our rational, logical brain. So people who are good at managing their emotions are less likely to be overwhelmed by stress or let it affect their lives. They are able to think before they take a leap and avoid jumping to conclusions. The trick here is to know that the emotional brain will be triggered first. We have to spend a little bit of time settling that before we can start to think about what we need to do next. I always think of the example of when there's been a bit of a crisis, what do people do? What do good British people do? Is they say, let's put the kettle on. And that in itself is just settling that emotional brain before we can think about what needs to happen next. Nearly there now, my next tip is flexible thinking. And this is a powerful social tool that helps us look at being optimistic, being able to adjust, be more rational, and try and think and find something positive in all situations. A person who has these skills is more likely to be emotionally resilient and well-balanced. And my last tip is looking at interpersonal relationships. Having good personal relationships is both a byproduct and a requisite for emotional resilience. If we have the power to build strong interpersonal bonds at a professional or personal level, we have already taken one step forward for a resilient life. So, it's time now for me to share with you the quote that we've chosen for this show. And we have chosen a quote by the legendary Nelson Mandela. And his quote is, "The greatest glory in living lies not in never failing, but in rising every time we fail." And here he was speaking about the power of persistence. More specifically, the power to get up day after day and fight all over again. That brings what he called glory. This makes us think about finding joy in our journey, trying to find joy where we can, even when it's hard for us. When we are in the depths of sadness or frustration or tiredness, it is hard to choose happiness. But I think knowing everything we do is learning, and we can learn from our depths, from the depths of despair, we can learn how far we have fallen. We need to remember that we can always get up. We also need to remember that this time will pass. Even if you're still feeling you're stuck in a real rut at the moment, there may be moments where you can find laughter or some small piece of joy. Moments when you can smile. Moments when maybe you can see the sunrise or the sunset. I certainly got up early this morning and saw the sunrise, and it was absolutely breathtaking. Experiencing life through the laughter of a small child. So just to remind you who Nelson Mandela is, I know I probably don't need to do this, but Nelson Mandela was absolute legend, certainly in my mind. He was a social rights activist, a politician, and an philanthropist, I can't even say that, and I'm not even going to try to, who became South Africa's first black president in 1984 to 1999. And Nelson Mandela joined the African National Congress in 1942. He will be remembered for his struggles and leadership for freedom, equality, truth, love, peace, and justice. He inspired many of us through his life, his struggles, his words, and his deeds as he walked the walk, as well as talking the talk. So I think this quote fits really well with our topic today for building resilience and how to be more resilient. So my question to you now is, what is the one small thing that you can do today or this week that will help you build resilience? We would love to hear your thoughts on what we've talked about today and on what you're going to do. Sharing a small goal with someone else, you could share it with us, is part of the process. It helps it make it more real and make it happen. So you can email the show, makingsense@wirralwave.co.uk, or you can follow us on socials and send us a message through there. We really, really would love to hear from you. So we have been talking about resilience, what it is, where you get it from, and how to get more. And I hope that that has been useful for you. Sometimes it is just good to pause and think about some of these things so that you can make yourself more aware. Self-awareness being a great tool. And I actually believe that being aware is 80% of any change. So I would like to... we would like to put another tune on. One of the most powerful tunes is Rise Up by Andra Day. I really hope you enjoy that.
You're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I rise up, I'll rise like the day. I rise up, I rise unafraid. I rise up and I do it a thousand times again. Silence is in quiet, and they're getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Move, I won't dance, bring it to its feet. Move, I won't dance, and I'll rise up. For that we have each other. I will rise a thousand times again, and we'll rise.
Okay, welcome back. So we are nearly at the end of our show. This is our second episode. Just to remind you, this show will be played out on Monday, 7 till 8 p.m. You may be listening now. It is also repeated on Thursday afternoons, 1 till 2, Friday, 7 till 8 p.m. and Sunday morning, 8 till 9 a.m. So there is plenty of opportunity for you to listen in. And as I've always said, we really want you to help us develop and create this show so that it is helpful to you. We would love to hear from you so that this show can be exactly what you want. As I've said, you can email the show anytime on makingsense at Wirral Wave Radio, or you can email the studio, studio@wirralwave.co.uk. If you have anything that you want to have shouted out, any of the presenters can do that for you here on Wirral Wave Radio. Okay, so in our next show, which is next month, February, we will be focusing on relationships. As it is the month of Valentine, we will be exploring the highs and lows of relationships. You may know that I have two books and one of them is all focused on relationships. So I will be bringing you some of the content from my second book, How to Make Sense of Relationships. You can message the show with your questions, topics that you want us to cover, if you have a question that you want us to cover, and we will try and answer it on the show for you if you do that. We will also be starting to organise guests, which we will reveal on our social media as time goes on. So please, please, please do message in. Let us know what you think. Let us know how you feel about the show. We really want to hear from you. So you have been listening to Making Sense at Wirral Wave Radio with Alison and George. Thank you so much for listening. Please do let your friends know about Wirral Wave Radio, your community show. Remember, no adverts. no adverts, I guess. No news, nothing depressing. It's all good, upbeat things. Lots of different styles of music across the week. Please do look on Wirral Wave Radio, wirralwave.co.uk's website, which gives a full schedule. And there's probably something for everybody. So we're going to leave you with I Will Survive, a really powerful powerhouse tune by Gloria Gaynor. I hope you have enjoyed the show. We have loved bringing it to you. I will say goodbye for now. Be kind to yourself, and we will see you all in 2 weeks' time. Bye-bye.
But then I spent so many nights